Today I want us to think of the tears of the Lord Jesus Christ. In John's Gospel, chapter 11, we have his tears of sympathy as he weeps at the grave of Lazarus. The story is that the Lord Jesus loved this family. But even though they were loved by the Savior, friend, Lazarus is sick. Because even as a Christian, you're not immune from trials, sickness, or even death itself. Mary and Martha think immediately of the Savior. They send a message to Christ. And in that message, they do not plead the virtue of Lazarus or even any virtue in them. But they plead the love of Christ. He whom thou lovest is sick. The Savior delays his coming. And then finally, he makes his way. You see, the Lord Jesus Christ did not race to that home because the Lord knew the end from the beginning. He knew that Lazarus would die, but he also knew that he would speak the word of authority and Lazarus would be raised from death and his father, and he would be glorified in that raising of Lazarus. When he came finally to that home, Martha meets him. And then she calls for Mary. They both say the very same thing. Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother would not have died. And somehow they emphasize the physical presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. But the Savior didn't need to be there to speak the word of authority. Do you remember the centurion whose servant was sick? And he said, I'm not worthy for you to come under my roof, but speak the word and my servant shall be healed. And he was. The Savior saw the tears of Mary and said, where have they laid him? He said, come and see. And as the Savior stands at the graveside of Lazarus, the Bible says Jesus wept. That word for weeping was not the same word as Mary's weeping, because Mary's was a cry that was loud, a wail that was heard. But Jesus wept was the silent flowing down of the tears along the cheeks of the Savior. As the Savior saw the sorrow that was in the heart of Mary and Martha, and he also saw the awful harvest that sin had brought, because sin doesn't bring forth life. Sin brings forth death. Tell me, have you ever wept over your sin? The tears of sympathy. And then in Luke's Gospel, chapter 19, it says, and when Jesus was come near, he beheld the city and wept over it. And there we see the tears of sorrow. When the Lord Jesus looked at the city of Jerusalem, he saw it different even from the disciples. You see, at this moment, the crowd were cheering the Lord Jesus Christ. They were said, blessed be the King. They had taken their garments. They had put the garments upon the colt and set the Savior upon it. They were taking him triumphantly into Jerusalem. They took their garments and spread it along the way. And yet Jesus wept. Because you see, the Savior saw the stubbornness of the hearts of the people. And even though they were cheering him today, in a few days' time, they would be crying, crucify him, crucify him. We will not have this man to rule over us. You see, he saw the rejection in their hearts and how fickle man's heart is. And he also saw the punishment that was before them. And he wept. That was a sob, a crying aloud over that city. And then in Hebrews chapter 5 it says, who in the days of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and supplications with strong crying and tears unto him that was able to save him from death. And there we see the tears of suffering, the awful agony the Savior entered into. Because you see, our sins were laid upon him. Ah, the mind of man could not comprehend. And the tongue of man could never express the awful agony that the Saviour would go through. And the Saviour cried aloud, as it says in Psalm 22, "Why art thou so far from helping me and from the words of my roaring?" The agony of Christ. We may not know, we cannot tell what pains he had to bear, but we believe it was for us. He hung and suffered there. The Saviour knows what you're going through. He sees your tears. Why don't you bring your heartache and your tears to Christ and let him wipe away all tears from your eyes? Come today. Heavenly Father, bless your word to our hearts for Jesus' sake. Amen. From my heart to yours, home to yours. God bless you.